First of all, we got a writer, okay? Okay, we got a writer. He's world renowned, okay? He's friends with celebrities, okay? He rubbernecks with celebrities in Los Angeles on beaches and shit. Nubo? No, what's it called? Nobu. That's where he eats fish and shit in front of Malibu waters and shit. Dolphins, they be out dancing. They be like, hi. He be like, sit. This person is an Indianapolis local legend. Hello. We like to give people their flowers while they're still alive. But wait a minute. Wait a minute, motherfucker. First of all, he's been a patron of VOCAB many, 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 many times, but he's never been on our stage. Do y'all know what we do for people who it's their first time coming to our stage? Okay, I can tell there's some people in here who did not know that. So now that y'all know, what we do is not a damn thing. But we say it all together in unison, hard. Like, we mean it. No damn thing. Y'all heard Chris Tucker back in Friday. Y'all seen the movie. And if you haven't, it is streaming right now for free. Depending on what apps you got, go watch. But for tonight, say it that way. What do we do for people who it's their first time, y'all? Wish my puppy was here so he could bark after you. Listen, not only are we not gonna do anything. My little friend said my laughter is like a scary witch laugh and it scares him, and I'd be like, more please. Listen, Maurice, all BS to the side, is like the pre-elder?
Baby elder.
He's the baby elder in training. Maurice is the reason that I wore what I wore. This is VOCAB. I could have wore gym shoes. I can't find my combat boots. I wore them to the photo shoot and haven't seen them since. I changed my shoes in my car and maybe somebody got in there and took them. I don't know. That's unrelated to what I'm talking about. Maurice is a superstar. And that's where we want to keep this, okay? I wore this coat so that I could flip it the way Maurice does, but there is some extra shit that's going to take place as he comes to the stage, and that's why we ain't doing a damn thing for him. However, we will acknowledge that Maurice is one of those people who literally brings his whole community with him wherever he goes, and we know that we are in Hollywood with him. Maybe just in spirit, not on the phone, not in the pictures, not at the table, not in the meetings, but we there in spirit, and he brings us, because he's our baby elder in training, and he loves us, and he instills so much value in all of us. So I'm going to say, coming to the stage, the VOCAB stage, for the first time, is Maurice. And then I'm going to count to three real quick. Right after I say that, and I don't want y'all to do anything. Don't make any noise. Guys, you should know how to do this because we've had to train you to make the noise. So let's try it. Coming to the stage. Coming to the stage. First time on. We love him. We respect him. We give him so much love and respect. Give it up for Maurice Broaddus. Who y'all heathens? Who the heathens? I saw it. You all the way in the darkest spot in the room, and I saw who did. Now I can't see you right now because you're hiding and ducking your face, but I saw who you was. I'm coming right over to you because you started a chain reaction. They didn't know what to do at this table. Okay? All right, I quit playing. Y'all, give it up. Are you going to stay there first?
No, wait for you to do your
thing. The thing is over, like, stand and... I'm going to say give it up for Maurice, and then I'm not going to be on the stage. Like, are you... you have items to give. Give it up for my mentor. He's the reason I'm not getting this rant, baby. Maurice Broaddus, sweep of the stars.
Oh my God.
the lock doors. Pause. The bulls wanna eat me by their lock jaws. Don't need to cook up the coat, you see me cop raw. And if you ain't had enough, what in the fat fishes of a phenomenal far from Dugan? Fuck is going on back with the B.A. The rack is careless. Bang on another song. I'm gonna have these niggas nervous and quick for these nails and dribbling and witness some nibbling.
How y'all doing? My name is Maurice Broaddus. So I'm like a science fiction and fantasy author. You know, I have over a dozen books out. I've had over 100 short stories published. What the hell am I doing on this stage? I write stories. That's what I do. And I've been invited into this sacred space, this space of poets. And I literally had one nightmare. Don't have to follow January York. Because I just write stories, that's all I do. You know, I gotta follow like January, and she's a poet. But she ain't like just a poet. She's like one of these multi-hyphenate artists types.
Right?
It's like, hi, I'm January York. I'm a poet and a model and a photographer and an astronaut and a superhero.
Cut his mic.
Nah, everything I touch is magic because my name is January York.
Cut his mic.
And then I got to follow that. This is where we are right now. So I write novels. All right, so can I tell you about my dude Sleepy?
Yes.
Sleepy?
Yes.
All right, so I have a novel, it's called Pimp My Airship. Yeah. It features one of my favorite characters I've ever written. His name is Sleepy, he's an open mic poet. Now, I don't know if any of y'all have like taken any like creative writing courses, but like, they'll always tell you one thing. Every protagonist in your story has to have a goal. They have to have something they're trying to accomplish. And Sleepy's goal in this book is he wants to get high. Hey. Nah, that's it. That's the whole journey. My dude just wants to get high and I won't let him. It's the whole book. So I thought I'd start off by reading the first time that Sleepy takes the stage in the book. So I figure I'd kick it off there. So this is from Pimp My Airship. Waiting until he made sure he was alone, Sleepy closed his eyes while he got into his mental place. He waited for the announcer to bring him out. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against rulers, against authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evils in the heavenly realms. The announcer spoke, low and breathy, into the mic, a seducing minister of the word. The time for games is over. The mission is clear. We fight to survive. We struggle to stay alive. You're either with us or against us. The cause is a state of mind. Some of us struggle with our past. Some of us struggle with our future. Some of us struggle with ourselves. We struggle against oppression. This is the good fight. Welcome with me the man who brings the fire, who brings the soul. The government knows him as Hubert Nixon, but we know him by another name. He's our brother. He's our friend. Set it off for us, Sleepy. Sleepy bumped shoulders with the announcer when they clasped hands. Stepping to center stage, the spotlight glared at him and the house lights dimmed. A gleam in his eyes, he inhaled and held his breath. He was in his moment, deep in his muse. When he opened his mouth, the words poured from a different place. I'd like to do a new piece for you. It's the first time I'm even hearing it out loud. It's called Let It Flow. The crowd applauded with encouragement and then settled down to allow Sleepy a moment to gather himself. The crowd applauded with encouragement. Two Too many thoughts crowding in my brain. I'm just so angry, so frustrated. I don't know where to begin. To unknot this cord inside my head, I just need to sit back, relax, and let the chiba flow. You see, my girl done left me, and I say, I don't pay that no mind. The first time in a while, I let myself relax. Been too long between girls. See, I got that charm. I got that smile. I got them words that burrow into your soul. I'm a mirror. Maybe they don't like what they see. Or maybe it's just me. I just need to sit back, relax, and let the chiba flow. I got me a job and I got no right to complain. Gonna work the same line, dawn till dark, all sweat and grime. In the end, I don't do nothing. I don't amount to nothing. I ain't changed nothing. Day in, day out, just another cog in a machine that grounds you up in its gears and would never know I was here. I just need to sit back, relax, and let the chiba flow. I wake up in the morning with nothing but the craving, the need to chill out and let my thoughts rise high, just wanting to escape, alone, not wanting to be alone, resigned to loneliness. Looking all around me, my soul cries out for more. I just need to sit back, relax, and let the chiba flow. Every time I share my story, I create a new history, stuck in a ghost spell truth the builders build. I'm wandering in the desert of our you and I verse, trying to overstand. Didn't know my father, couldn't save my mother, couldn't save my brother. I need to get out so I can at least save me. I just need to sit back, relax, and let the chiba flow. So where can a brother get a light? Well, that was that piece. Oh! Yeah. So the crazy part is, like, literally the next line in the book is, the pause when he finished was always the longest, most unbearable stretch of seconds. The held breath of the audience deciding if his piece was to be received well. That's literally the next line in the book. So, yeah, thank you for that.
We read it.
Yeah, I see that. So I wrote this whole novel, Pimp My Airship, right? And I was trying to work out this thing in my head because I'm just like, you know what? I'm at a new place in my life and I'm trying to do something real with my life, but I'm just a writer. So how do I use my art to, like, change the world? How do I use my art to, like, make the world a better place, to make some real change in my community, in my neighborhood? And that was literally the theme I was trying to work out in Pimp My Airship. And so as I take Sleepy on his little journey of, becoming woke, I guess. And I just keep throwing stuff at Sleepy. He's trying to get high, and I'm like throwing stuff at him. I'm throwing the police at him. I'm throwing jail at him. I'm throwing the KKK at him. I'm throwing giant robots at him. Look here, I make him earn his high. But Sleepy does make it to the end of the novel. And this next piece is what he performs in the epilogue of the book. All right, so I have this new piece that I've been working on. It's called Hole in the Soul, a Work in Progress. I hope you enjoy it. Sleepy took a step away from the microphone and took a sip from his cup of water. He wanted the silence to be on them, pressing like a weight to create a spell to captivate them. You'll always be my daddy. I'll always be your son. Here I am, a grown-ass man, and I don't even know what that means. I look to God and call him father, but all I know about fathers comes from you, and I never knew you. Oh, you were around while growing up. You came through ready to hang out, be my friend. You always had jokes or a dirty magazine or a cigarette or a drink to share, because, yeah, you were a Cools and Crown and Coke man. My friends thought you were the coolest dad on the block. But the block had you more than we did. And I wasn't looking for a friend. Daddy just lift me up. All I ever wanted was for you to hold me and claim me as yours. Daddy lift me up. bloodshot eyes, liquor on your breath. I swallow your thoughts of me and slowly starve. Fathers and sons full of mystery and history, and how can he love someone like me? I can hear the disappointment in his voice up on the auction block of my childhood. See, I'm not that smart, not that funny. Certainly not the life of the party like he was. A depressed mess, too dark and left behind. A hypocrite like me, a sinner like me. A me like me. What I think when I think of God, my Father, is that he's supposed to be distant, to come around when he feels like it, to make me laugh during the good times, but never around when times got hard. You know, he might peel me off a 20, maybe throw a blessing my way, make up for his absence. But it wasn't like I could count on him or know him. So now I'm not that anxious to get to know that Father, to believe that he loves me for me, to believe that he considers me valuable simply because I'm me. Daddy, just lift me up. All I ever wanted was for you to get to know me and to show that you actually like having me around. Daddy, lift me up. See, the idea of being daddy scares me. A father's fears consoling a little boy's tears. I don't know if I want that burden of revealing God to my own children, to be a reflection of our true Father. I don't know if I have enough love to give, or if I'm even brave enough to let them into my heart. To know what love I have, to know and be known, to risk being a daddy. You see, I want to go to all of their recitals, knowing that they'll suck, and cheer them anyway. I want to be able to enter their world, learn who they are, and help shape them into the best them they can be. I never want to be too tired to play catch or be there to talk. I never want to leave them with a hole where their father should be. A father's lies, a father's cries, shedding a father's tears, proud for who you are, who you can be. Father, just lift me up. All I ever wanted is to love and be loved the way I knew you would want me to. Perfect love drives out fear. So Father, lift me up. Like, that was actually the first real poem I ever wrote. Thank you. But hang on, that's not counting like all the poems I wrote in high school, all those depressed, you know what I'm saying. No, ain't none of us here for that. You know all that. I stared into the abyss and the abyss stared into me.
You were an AC teenager?
I know, right? So yeah, I'm trying to do all that. And I'm also not counting the poems I wrote for my wife, Sally, because, you know. Because it definitely wasn't because I forgot our anniversary and came up with something at the last minute. What? Sorry, I blacked out for a second. I was using my outside voice. But plus, she has to love them because, you know, 22 years. She got to love them. That's right, 22 years. Are we allowed to do covers here?
Yeah, whatever you want
to
do.
All right, bet. All right, so I have a new trilogy out right now, or actually I have book one of a trilogy. The trilogy is called Astra Black, and book one is called Sweep of Stars. And people are like, oh man, that's a great title. I'm like, yeah, I stole that. I stole that from a poet. Because if you're gonna steal from the best, right? So this one I stole from Langston Hughes. Right? They said Christopher Columbus. Anyway, you know what? Langston Hughes had a poem called Stars. And it's a poem that impacted me a lot. So I thought I'd share that poem with you. And in this poem, you actually hear all three titles of my trilogy, because I got Sweep of Stars, Breath of Oblivion, and A City Dreaming. That's the full trilogy I'll be having out here soon. So for you, Langston Hughes's poem, Stars. Oh, sweep of stars over Harlem streets. Oh, little breath of oblivion that is night. A city dreaming to a mother's song. A city dreaming to a lullaby. Reach your hand. Reach up your hand, dark boy, and take a star out of the little breath of oblivion that is night. Just take one star. Thank you. So like I said, that was a poem that really impacted me and was part of the inspiration for this trilogy. I wanted to read a little bit of Sweep of Stars, which is a story that takes place about 100 years from now. It's about an intergalactic community led by us, built by us,
boo-boo,
on our terms. Thank you. So here's a little bit from chapter one of Sweep of Stars. Your name is Leah Adisa, for now. Choosing a name for yourself is not something to be entered into lightly. It's a promise you make to the universe, or it to you. A name is a story of yourself that you present to the world, a label to define you. That's the entire point of the naming ceremony. You are finally of age to interpret yourself and enter into the Muungano community as a full, free member. Now, because this is an Adisa renaming, the entire Ijo governing body travels from all over the Muungano Alliance. The sovereign territory centers around the lunar outpost and the facility which serves as its capital, the Dreaming City. Named after an old tale the wise ones whispered when it was time for bed, a place full of Orisha and magic and the old ways. From Bronzeville on Mars to Titan, and even the distant Oyijiji mining outpost, members make this voyage. It's only a couple weeks travel at sublight, but many representatives want to make this pilgrimage. Even the fabled research ship is due to dock at any time. The members of the community experience two naming ceremonies. You don't remember your first. It came 7 days after your birth on original Earth. By the hollow accounts, family and neighbors gathered together to celebrate and welcome you into the world, imitating the rituals they'd heard about that was carried on Muungano. You were given the name of a distant ancestor in your family, and it's fitting that you chose this day for the day of your second. You love landing into the Dreaming City. As your shuttle disembarks from the array, two bisecting arms, known as the belt, span the circumference of the moon in a curving perpendicular lattice looming over you. The string of crawls, arranged in a long line, the series of modules gird the moon in orbit over the Dreaming City. Descending on a vector to the building with spires radiating from its dome, the many-rayed architecture made it appear like a setting sun coming into view. With its giant columns and skyports and blur of lights, it's a gleaming bauble filling the horizon. Still, you yearn for more. The stars call to you. If not Mars, then certainly Titan, or maybe even worlds beyond. You dream of a truly outer space and the magic of the stars. Actually, before I go on, I'm gonna need your help with something. So have you heard the phrase Ashe?
Yes.
All right, so Ashe, for those who don't know, it basically means so be it, or it's the power to make things happen. Some people treat it like amen, but when I do this, I'm gonna need y'all to say Ashe, all right?
Got you.
Do you?
I got it.
All right, hang on.
Try it out.
All right. Be alert for your part. Representatives from each of the seven governing families of Muungano assemble at the gathering of the Ijo. The full ruling body meets rarely. The elders of each kraal typically organizes their represented community. There's little need for the collective elders to actually come together except on special occasions, or simply to just enjoy being in the community of one another, delighting in one another as if attending a family reunion. The room radiates around a large table, symbolic more than anything else, as it couldn't seat the entirety of family, much less the full Ijo. But it's the traditional gathering place for a family meeting. A team of 20 drummers strike up a beat and line up at the front of the great hall of the Dreaming City. Behind them, a storm of dancers hop in place, allowing space for the drummers to proceed. Before spacing out along the pathway to twirl their scarves, green, yellow, black, mirroring your outfit, they synchronize their movement, a formation of limbs jerking and swaying, bobbing along the syncopated heartbeat of the pounding rhythm. Crowds of people line either side of the sidewalk. You've never seen so many of your people assembled at once, here in this place, in this time. They echo the old ways. They dress a sea of kente cloth, kaftans and head wraps, bold colors, different patterns representing the various families. Though you know it's not the case, it seems like all of Muungano has turned out for your renaming. Once you complete the ceremony, the next step will be for you to be formally invited to the Ijo as a ranking member of the Adisa family. And suddenly, dread gnaws in your stomach. Serving as the officiating elder, Bayard stands next and follows the dancers, his every step slow and considered. He carries a large staff, which he raises according to his own internal rhythm, turns it on its side as if to bar anyone from approaching. Camarazola marches next, alongside an empty chair held aloft by four members of the Nai Benji. Under ordinary circumstances, he would serve as the officiating elder, but because this is your ceremony, he defers to Bayard and instead serves as libator so that he may lead the family processional. As he steps onto the pathway, a holographic image flares to life. Mother Selah, despite being in her sickbed, projects an image of herself. Her hologram seems to stare towards the horizon of Muungano. She turns to look down at you, outstretching her fingers to brush yours, a ghost of light projections they pass through your hands. Wachira brings up the rear. His features favor his father, though his complexion is several shades darker. He hoists a large umbrella, a token meant to shield the Queen Mother during the processional. He turns to you and nods, his eyes warming and inviting, but distant in that way he never quite focuses on anyone in particular. Four members of the Nai Benji follows the professional as the rear guard. When you arrive at the center dais, the guards disperse to the four corners of the stage. A hush falls over the crowd without Bayard doing anything beyond taking center stage. To destroy the identity of a people, he begins, you must first strip them of their name, strip them of their sense of self. Your name joins you to your family, your history, your culture. We struggled a long time and hard to reclaim our birthright and control of ourselves. Today, we honor our right to define ourselves on our terms. Leah Adisa, before whom do you vow? Nayami, the Orisha, my honored ancestors, my family, the Adisa, the people of Muungano. What name do you choose for yourself? Amachi, you proclaim. Turning to the gathering, you define your name. Who knows what God has brought us through this child? His lips broadening into a well-pleased smile, Camarazola stifles a snort. Not wanting the moment broken, Bayard cuts him a slight, chastening glare before continuing. As you say, so shall it be. Beloved community of Muungano, I present to you Amichi, Leah Adisa. Hail, 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 Camarazola cries and steps forward, addressing the community. May happiness come. The people of Muungano shout in response.
Ashe.
Wherever we join to make a circle, may our chain be complete.
Ashe.
Wherever we dig a well, may we come upon water.
Ashe.
May it be darkness behind the stranger who has come and light before her.
Ashe.
May her mother and father have a long life.
Ashe.
May she eat by the labor of her hands.
Ashe.
May she show respect to the world.
Ashe.
May her path be straightened before her.
Ashe.
Life and prosperity to her children.
Ashe.
May we leave whole and may we return whole.
Ashe.
And may happiness come and the people of Mungano erupted.
Ashe. Ashe. Ashe.
And that's that piece.
Where's the theme song?
Now, for the stinking fairies, I'm waiting for a lady to treat for us. You have a Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram.